geometric drawing number 5. Draw in the suggested positions the following views of the octagonal prism. Octagonal, 8-sided prism, meaning straight up. An end elevation, a surface development. That's of the upright sides, not of the cuts. So I'll number the corners. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'll carry those down. 3 with 2 at the back. 4 with 1 at the back. 5 with 8 at the back. 6 with 7 at the back. And 5 dash and 8 dash will be at that height. And we'll have 2 heights for each of those 2 lengths. And we'll have 2 heights and 2 cuts for those. And we're drawing the end view looking into the cut, so it's nearest. So there will be no hidden detail in this view. Right, we're going to project across here. We're going to get our heights across here, but we'll need the widths from the plan. Project off one view, size off another. We'll extend, we'll use our abatement line method by just extending the centre line up and along. 45 degrees pointing in towards the front elevation. And then it's just a matter of projecting across to the abatement line. To draw the full elevation first. Need to extend my XY line. I'm extending that along to there because I know I need a surface development later. So all I need now is my total height, and that's the uncut octagonal prism drawn. I'm going to label it just to help me with the cuts. Look in here, and point 3 is nearest me. Point 2 is there, 1 is there, 4 is there. Now that's the numbers at the front. The ones what's at the back of number 4 is 5. So that's the furthest away ones are 5. The one that's furthest away, now that one's not cut, so I'm not going to bother with that one. That one's not cut, so I'm not going to bother with 7. I'll need 8, and 8 is behind number 1. I'm now looking here, and I'm going to draw one line at a time. Line number 3, corner number 3 is cut. Point and at that point. Likewise, number 2 is cut at that point and that point. This one, which is 4 and 1. I've cut at that. 4 and 1. I've cut at that height. 4 and 1. And I've also cut at that height. 4 and 1. And we're looking at this back point now. That just touches 5 and 8. So 5 and 8. And behind 4, so 5 is there. And 8 is there. And by joining the dots up, it comes along there, slopes up, continues up. Now, these lines are going to go all the way, so we'll just draw those the full height. Comes up to the top, but there's a line across, there's a change of direction. So we show that change of direction by drawing a line along, and then we carry on joining the upper points. Drawn, it's a shaped block, it's not shown any cutting planes, so we can just treat it as an object. We don't have to do any hatching. Always make sure you line your drawings in. Don't leave in ever in construction lines. And that's as far as the drawing goes, but we've also got the two lines at the back that go the full height, which are there and there, which are lines that go right up the back of that. Now that line stops there and there, but the back will see hidden detail. So change the inside of those, that construction line, to hidden detail. And that one there. And that's the drawing done. But now what we have to do is we have to do a development. So I'm going to start off with just a vertical line. I'm just going to start at number 1 and I'm going to measure along. That's going to be number 1. So I need the true distance between 1 and 2, 3, 4, etc. Now because it's a regular octagon, it means there's 8 sides all the same length. So with my compass, I take the true size between 1 and 2 because it's straight down on that edge. So the distance between 1 and 2, and then step it. So that's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and back to number 1. I'm going to draw construction lines, and the heights of the total prism aren't altered. So that enables me to draw a straight line right across those, because all of those shapes go right up to the top. So each panel is a side of the octagon. Now we're going to look at corner one. Corner one we've got here, it's cut at that height and at that height. So by just purely projecting across, that's where line number one. At number two is cut there and there. Line three is cut at the same height. Five is the center point. It's cut at a single point. Which is that point there. Six is not cut at all. Six is still the full height. Seven is not cut at all. Eight is a single point. So eight is that single point there. So six, seven, eight is a single point. And one is cut there, so I'll just project across from there. And I've got two shapes, one there and one there. That is the development of it. But we can't leave it like this. We have to line in our drawings or outline our drawings. This is a fold line. That's the development of the suffix.